Thank you. Staying with our German theme, we've got Markus Glasser, who's the Senior Vice President for Export EOS GmbH Electro-Optical Systems, and he'll be talking about digital smart factories of the future and industrial 3D printing, one of its key drivers.
Good afternoon, and I would like to take you to a 50-minute journey through the world of industrial 3D printing. Industrial 3D printing, I assume everybody of you have heard about it. Keywords like freedom of design, make the impossible possible, digitalization, industry 4.0, there are many words about it. I would like to illustrate you on the example of EOS, the dynamic growth of industrial 3D printing. So it took EOS about 20 years to sell the first 1,000 systems globally. The second 1,000 systems were sold within 5 years. And the third 1,000 systems were sold within 2.5 years. That means this shows also the strong growth in this industry, and we can all assume what kind of potential is even behind this industry. Just a few facts about EOS. The company located in Munich, in Germany, 350 million euro is the yearly revenue, 1,250 people are employed worldwide, and the growth rate per year is about 20% about the last 2 years. 3D printing, so it's graduating from a niche of prototyping and rapid tooling over the last almost 30 years to industrial production. That means in the very beginning we had prototyping. So now, let's say the last 2 or 3 years, we are in the pre-production phase. The systems are robust, they can produce a lot of components. Companies are doing production, they select the part for production, they do validation for the production. So this is what we are moving at the moment. The next 3 years, the next step is to move into production. It means embed the technology into conventional production environments. That means also the systems have to be aligned, that the technology has to grow. So there are a lot of demands also for us as a supplier to the industry. Now I would like to pay attention to these three key success pillars. So number one, technology leadership, what we have today. Very important, innovation with quality. So quality is key, and this comes always first. Of course, we need to work on automation, we need to work on quality, we need to work on productivity of the systems. Number two, digitalization. Digitalization supports the move of the industries towards the smart factories of the future. And also thirdly, EOS is building up a large ecosystem with partners that we can support the entire value chain of the customers, as such also offer complete solutions to the customers. That means on the one hand side we have partners in the upstream side, which means software and data. On the other side we have partners in the downstream for post-processing, for post-milling. And I just would like to give you two examples. One example, upstream. So we work together with companies like Siemens or SAP to work on the on the software interfaces or the software integration. And on the other hand side, on the downstream, we work together, for instance, with a company like called Georg Fischer Machining Solution to develop the interfaces between our 3D printing technology to conventional machining. Industrial 3D printing, one of the key drivers towards digital smart factories. So smart factories are developed within the framework of Industry 4.0. It's all about digital disruption, and we believe the next disruption wave is in the field of production. That means industrial 3D printing is one of the key drivers to develop towards digital smart factories. That means also for companies who wants to start, wants to introduce 3D printing, there are a few topics to pay attention in order to be successful. Number one is industrial 3D printing introduce a disruptive change in the organization. That means company have to develop and have to adjust for it. Also, they have to build up a knowledge about 3D printing in their organizations. Thirdly, the technology itself, the implementation of technology, software, powders, is the role of the technology providers like us. And also our software suites will help to support all on those factors, which is key to use our technology in production. Okay, a few pillars are missing, sorry about that. Next step, introduce innovation, disruptive transformation. So if you want to integrate it, what does it mean? You need to consider overcome the inventor's dilemma. That means switch the perspective if you change from conventional production environment to industrial 3D printing. It means take a part and redesign it to the maximum benefit. The part production can be done per production need, so you can always align the production. Secondly, you need to close the knowledge gap within your organization to master the 3D printing transformation. Thirdly, also, if you introduce such technology in the organization, you need a broad commitment on all levels of the company. That means you need the top down, you need a commitment on the visionaries level, so visionaries on the top. We need a commitment bottom up, so the ambassadors on the project level who drive at the end this 3D printing transformation. And also you need, if you integrate such technology, you need to switch completely your way of thinking in design and manufacturing. So you should stop to think in the limitation of conventional production methods. So just let it fall down, think impossible designs, because now you can really produce from a perspective design-driven manufacturing. What did we learn? The last 2 years, our consulting group, we call it EOS Additive Minds, have worked on about 300 consulting projects with customers. And the main topic was to help customers to introduce industrial 3D printing in the organization. And they have detected 4 main phases what each customer, each company has to go through. And in these 4 phases we can help the customers to be faster, to get support, and to integrate faster the 3D printing technology. That means number one, if you say I would like to start and would like to get in touch with industrial 3D printing, first of all, you need to look whether you have the right part. So you need to screen your part portfolio and see, is there any part which can be produced additive, which can be used in 3D printing. If this is possible and if this is existing, comes the next stage, and this is develop your application. That means you take the part and redesign the part that it fits for 3D printing. Or, if possible, even take a complete new approach and design it from the scratch that you have the full benefits of the part design. Number 3 is then, if you have managed this one, that you ramp up your production. That means you need to decide, do you want to set up a 3D printing production environment, basically mainly out of 3D printing machines, or do you want to integrate 3D printing machines in a conventional production environment? That means if this is done, the last step is then to scale your production. That means you implement full-scale production of your part, whatever you want to produce. And then you certify your production. And this is very often a very demanding approach, and is also this demands you need if you work, for instance, towards aerospace companies, medical customers, which have a high demand on the product, on the certification. So coming now a few slides about EOS. So EOS is offering market-leading polymer and metal technologies which can be used for high-end production. That means recently we integrated the plastic sintering, the polymer system on the market. It's called P500, and this is built for large scale production. That means if you do large scale production, you need to work on productivity, on reproducibility of parts, so that you have always the same part quality, that you can scale up your system, that you have a quality control. There are a lot of factors what you have to focus, as I said in the very early beginning, that you integrate this technology in production. A few more. So with the system, EOS continuously works on powders and processes. That means we provide processes, powders, and systems, and we talk there about a triangle. And this triangle makes sure that we have best quality and highest productivity. So very shortly, I can tell you, we have around 35 materials for plastic metal available at EOS, which we can use for the technologies. We have 120 processes validated. We can offer customized powder and processes to customers if requested. And we also offer digital powders, which gives a lot of new abilities and much more mechanical properties as today. What does it mean? For instance, if you imagine a powder which has a magnetic behavior, which gives you a complete new scope of applications. Thirdly, the software. So we have different software legs. EOS Sprint, which is our process software, where we can have a CAD data integration. EOS Connect, where we can integrate our software in MES, ERP systems. And EOS State, which is a software where you can use it for quality assurance. It means that you understand, is your build job, what you do, okay or not. So this is the software tool. Oops. Before I come to the end, one example. So EOS and Under Armour, which is the leading player, or one of the leading players in the sport footwear, have signed a cooperation agreement. So it means EOS and Under Armour develop and optimize the 3D printing process, including pre- and post-processing, in order to produce high-performance footwear. That means we want together digitalize the footwear market. Oops, goes always too fast. Just now to summarize the conclusion. So it was a short overview about how 3D printing can transform your business. And there are at the end two players left. The one player, which is the manufacturer who will disrupt the market, and the other one, whose business will be disrupted. That means take the chance, if you would be involved, and be one of those which disrupt the market. Thank you very much.